We are surrounded by technology which is improving by the second. Back in the day, we had an alarm clock only for the purpose of setting the alarm. A radio to listen to music. A calculator for arithmetic operations. But now, all of them have been integrated on a single device.
Our smartphones aid us with multiple benefits. They don't cause a noticeable delay when we open multiple apps together. Smartphone is not the only device that has improved with time. These devices can multitask within nanoseconds. How do you think the engineers have made this possible?
One of the major reasons for this breakthrough is decreasing the propagation delay. Let's say you are at position A and you have to reach a destination D. There are several ways to reach the destination. But what is the shortest path?
It's the straight path given by Pythagoras' theorem from A to D. The distance covered is 5 kilometers. Now, if you have to go to destination E, you would take the shortest path. The total distance covered is 10 kilometers. However, had we traveled from A to E in a straight path, we would have covered distance in 6 kilometers. That is, going to destination D has delayed the process.
Inside digital systems, millions of combinational logical circuits are used. If you can remove redundant processes, it will make the system faster and decrease the production cost. For this, it is important to learn what math goes behind the logic gates.
You can check our previous videos on logic gates. So, to answer the question, Boolean algebra is the mathematics of logic.
I know how much learning algebra has troubled us. For example, normal algebra includes variables which can take infinite values.
Boolean algebra is simpler. The variables can take only two values, 0 and 1.
Algebra says the symbol plus means addition and dot means multiplication.
In Boolean algebra, AND operation is signified by a dot. For this example, the expression is read as x and y. And Boolean OR operation is noted by a plus. It is read as x or y. It's very important that we pronounce them this way and not call them x into y.
In the above equation, x and y are two literals.
We have listed some famous theorems to make things simpler.
De Morgan's law. It is about group complementation. Consider A and B as two inputs of AND gate. The Boolean expression is A and B. We take a complement of this expression.
Complement is signified by a bar over the entire expression. If you recall, this is NAND gate expression. Let us expand this function and see what we get. We can start by taking complement of all the individual variables. Complement of A is A bar. Complement of AND operation is OR. And complement of B is B bar. What do we have here? A and B bar is A bar or B bar. Let us represent the Boolean expression using gates. A and B bar is a Boolean expression for a NAND gate. To represent A bar or B bar, let us first draw the OR gate. There are two inputs, A and B. However, both are inverted. So we connect the NOT gate. This gives us A bar and B bar.
These inputs go to an OR gate. The Boolean expression is A bar or B bar. Thus NAND gate is equivalent to a bubbled OR gate. The bubble indicates the NOT operation. It can also be proved using the truth table. By now, we are familiar with the truth table for a NAND gate.
Let's fill the values for A bar.
It is simple inversion. 0 gets inverted to 1 and 1 gets inverted to 0. Let us fill the last column, A bar or B bar. When both the inputs are 1, OR gate produces a high output. The output continues to be 1 when any of the inputs is high. When both the inputs are 0, the output is 0.
Well, the values match.
Aren't you guys curious to know if the same applies for a NOR gate? For inputs A and B, the output is A NOR B. We have A bar and B bar.
NOR gate can be written as inverted AND gate.
Let us do the exercise of filling the truth table to derive it. There is a trick to apply De Morgan's theorem. Consider the logical expression A and B bar.
We will break the bar equally.
So the variables get complemented and invert the logical expression. So AND operation gets inverted to OR operation. Consider this expression. We have two complement terms. Always start with the bigger complement. We break the complement equally. This term is in double complement form. The first complement inverts the term and the second complement reverts it to original. Hence the complement disappears. This is the final expression.
Thank you for watching this video. In the next video, we will see the remaining laws of Boolean algebra. Subscribe to the channel to stay updated.
And please like us so that we keep providing more videos.
Wish you a happy new year. Stay calm and keep learning. Peace out.